Update from Microsoft presents The News Hour with Arnab Goswami.
Within 2 days, Shaheen has gone from being the free-spirited girl who questioned the shutdown of her city to the girl who is so crushed that she has shut down her Facebook page out of fear, targeted, humiliated, harassed, forced to apologize. Is this the price for exercising your freedom of expression in a democracy?
Little bit scared. Little, not more.
Targeted, humiliated, harassed. All because she posted a message on Facebook questioning the Mumbai shutdown. The 21-year-old forced to cover her face as the fear instilled in her lingers on. The hapless victim recounting the most harrowing incident for just speaking her mind.
What do you have to say about that particular incident? Whatever happened was not right. The whole hospital has been vandalized. That's it. It was not right, whatever happened.
So what did you think of the fact that, you know, later the police took action against you, they arrested you and your friend who merely shared your comment, only endorsed your view. What did you think of that?
It was unfair.
Do you still stand by the fact that you feel cheated in the way the state treated you?
No comment. Yes.
I mean, do you feel that it was a little strict and over the top, the action?
Yes.
But a day later, the same girl who spoke her mind on a social networking site was forced to apologize for her comment.
Actually, whatever happened after that, police came and they just told me to apologize and I did that. Then I got to know that many are hurt. So I apologized.
Okay, so the police advised that you should apologize because that's the best way to end this debate.
Yes.
This only sparking massive furor across the nation.
Bombay police of late has been behaving in a very strange fashion where civil liberties are concerned. To arrest this person is a constitutional blasphemy. And to do this to this girl is again a constitutional atrocity, and I think it's about time somebody took the cops to task.
Sort of an attitude of the state is shocking. I strongly condemn it. This is a complete misuse of the police.
While serious questions are being raised over the handling of the entire episode, the trauma that this 21-year-old underwent is irreparable. Will the rest of India sit back, watch and do nothing as the two young girls are harassed, humiliated and targeted for simply speaking their mind? Has the state government drawn the link between how the attack happened after the girl refused to apologize to the local Shiv Sena man? Bureau Report, Times Now.
On the News Hour tonight, Aryaman Sundaram, senior advocate of the Supreme Court. We are broad-basing the subject tonight to the whole question of vandalism, because unless this is defined and called vandalism, then it can get confused with some form of political activism, which it is not. Aryaman Sundaram is with us tonight from Delhi. Also with us is Ranjana Kumari, director of the Center for Social Research from Delhi, well-known activist. Mohandas Fai, well-known entrepreneur, formerly of Infosys, is with us tonight. M.N. Singh, former Mumbai Police Commissioner, to my right. To my left, I have Shaina N.C. of the BJP. To her left, Abha Singh, senior advocate and social activist. And Shweta Parulekar, my first question is to you, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena. Thank you very much. Ms. Parulekar, why are you seeking to justify this?
Simply.
Why are you seeking to justify?
No, it's very unfortunate whatever has happened.
No, but why are you justifying?
No, I'm not justifying in the real sense. But the thing is that the time at which it happened, after the funeral procession went off without any kind of incidents happening, and the police did a marvelous job.
No, what does this have to do with the police doing a marvelous job?
No. What they did at that point was right for that moment, I think. That
what did they do which was right at that moment? The police?
Yeah.
What did they do?
They arrested these girls.
You think you're justifying it?
Simply because maybe it would have gone out of proportion.
No, what did the girls do wrong? Why did they have cases filed against them? Why were they picked up?
See, Arnab, I think that when you talk about freedom of expression, it comes with duties also which the citizens should remember, especially at the time when the time was so sensitive and when they are talking about a mass leader and Mumbai shutting down, nobody had, compelled anybody. It was a spontaneous thing which
happened.
Now,
who do you arrest if somebody goes and vandalizes Ms. Parulekar, somebody vandalizes?
See, that was a reaction, Arnab.
Reaction
that was,
means
that was not an action. They didn't do it first. I'm not justifying that either.
200 people coming and breaking down a hospital is a justified reaction?
Definitely not.
So why is your party not attacking those people who did it, demanding their immediate confinement, demanding they be locked up for a long time, that they meet examples of,
but
that their pictures put up everywhere so that the fear goes into their hearts as well, that they will be embarrassed and shamed if this were to happen again?
With this particular incident, I think that this was a reaction. It was very unfortunate this happened, but if they would have posted their status more responsibly.
No, what was irresponsible?
Well, talking about him when he has such a lot of following on the very day when this
people
particular
may have different
happened.
Views.
So also that reaction was a view.
So what reaction? You go break down a hospital, that's a view. Break down the hospital, take the patients out, drag them out.
That I'm not
smash
see,
the whole
I'm,
place
I'm
up
again
into
and again saying that I'm not justifying that or not.
No, so if anyone out of those people, if today you would say that girl out there or somebody else, or somebody on the street says, I disagree with what you say and I am going to smash your homes, burn your buildings.
No.
Pick up people from the hospitals.
It is related to this particular situation.
No,
I think
so
we're talking
different
about
different situations, different
every
sentiment.
Day, everybody are giving their opinions on the social network, etc. And that these things are not happening
question,
at that time.
Ms. Parulekar, please examine this. This attempt to put fear will not last. And let me tell you clearly, those who try and instill fear like this must know that this country has changed. Your methods must change. You want to use those methods on a young, expressive India, they will speak back at you. There will be possibly, Ms. Parulekar, a counter movement against this kind of vandalism. It's not going to be acceptable. It's not democracy. It's lumpenism. Lumpenism must be called lumpenism. Why are you measuring your words today? Let's get in Abha Singh. Abha Singh, what do you make of the justifications provided so far?
See, Sunday this city went without milk. The city went without food. So why? This was because there was a fear factor. These two young girls are apologizing for what? They are not members of a party. They are just expressing a personal comment. And if for that comment, the police lands in their house, fixes them up, uses a wrong section of spreading communal hatred and then changes it. When the CRPC 46-4 clearly says that you cannot arrest girls after sunset and before sunlight, that is police is violating, and the city is seeing that when the mighty police is under the threat and fear of political vandalism, what is the common man going to do?
So in this case, the problem is the state gives in.
The state has given in. Even the police constables who were vandalized, who in the recently when the women cops were molested, was because of that. Because the fear factor of the police has also gone. Because it is using wrong tactics at wrong times.
No, I want to get Aryaman Sundaram at this stage. You're attacking the state, I know. But you're not saying a word about the Shiv Sainiks who are responsible for this. Why?
That's a coalition, of course.
There are two aspects to this. Clearly, the girls had a right to freedom of expression. The police acted inappropriately. And I think this question about vandalism, everybody wants I'm not at all uncomfortable, Arnab. The guilty need to be brought to task. But the police who acted in this arbit manner need to be suspended immediately.
What about the people who
you have
this?
A Prithviraj Chauhan who's
quiet. What about the people
quiet.
Who did this? Don't politicize it.
You have a Prithviraj Chauhan who's quiet.
Don't politicize it.
Isn't the police
don't
equally responsible?
No.
Who arrested? Did the Shiv Sena arrest these girls or did the police?
No, one second.
The police need to reply.
This case is very clear. The case is one of violence. Shaina, who carried out the violence?
I am not defending them.
Who carried out the violence?
I am not. My heart
them?
Goes
who
out to
them?
The girls.
No, I'm not asking you where your heart goes out.
Whoever,
I'm asking who carried out the violence.
Whoever has vandalized.
Who carried out the violence?
It works very well for you to try and get an answer from me.
No, but I'm only here to ask questions. You must give me the answer. No, because you are in an alliance with the Shiv Sena, you can't dodge the question.
Identify in large political parties.
I am asking the police. I will ask the police the questions as well.
To respond as to who were the people
who vandalized. Who
was it?
Who vandalized? You see, it is very clearly said that the Sainiks vandalized the girl's uncle's hospital.
You're because, choosing to because the
girls
one
because
aspect.
The girls no I'm not because
You're
the girl refused
choosing,
to apologize.
Why were well, the even girls when the
girl
the
even, even when the girl apologized, she added it was a casual comment and maintained it was a crime.
Absolutely.
I am asking you today, of course the state is being silent, but what about the vandals?
They
Tell me what should be done about the vandals.
Should be punished.
What about the vandals?
They need to be punished immediately. They need to be punished immediately.
The vandals are let off on bail for 7,500 rupees each, while the girls out there have gone through a trauma which I am sure you can empathize with. Why are you being soft on the vandals?
I am not at all soft on the vandals. I said first and clearly that the girls were completely right. Freedom to expression, and we are not in the medieval times to have an informed opinion or an ill-informed opinion is your prerogative. It is a democracy. The beauty of our democracy is that girls across the country should be in a position to say what they want.
No, would
and
you
without
say today? Would you say
fervor.
Today? Would you
but
say
the fear
to, you are
is
not? You are not saying one word against.
Police?
You are not saying one
I am
word
not, I
against
am
those who carried out the violence. I wonder why.
I
You're keeping your political options.
We are under fear.
You're saying she's under fear.
No, even we are under fear because everybody's trying to be a little diplomatic today.
No,
because tomorrow when we go back, we would find these people under our houses shouting.
If the vandals are Shiv Sainiks, they need to be punished. If the vandals are just normal people who are making the most of a situation, they need to be punished. But first and foremost, the police officer who suspended the girl needs to be punished.
Who put the pressure on the family? Who carried out the violence on the hospital? Who, Shaina?
The police needs to answer.
Who did the police carry out the violence?
No, but the police need to answer why.
Let's go to
No,
I think we must be clear on both sides. Fear cannot be a factor anymore in our democracy. We cannot be fearful of vandals. We must stand up to them. We must look them in the eye. And we must tell them that they do not have the right to take the law into their own hands.
The vandals
that is the only message they need to get, and then we need to tell the state, don't abdicate your responsibility. Otherwise, unfortunately, in the words of a certain gentleman, we'll become a banana republic. I want to get in Aryaman Sundaram at this stage. Aryaman Sundaram, what do you make of this particular case and the fact that this poor girl has not just been forced to apologize after the trauma she's gone through, but actually her trauma is being doubled and tripled all over again because she's suffering humiliation at the hands of the state?
Arnab, I must say that I find your question about whether we should decry the vandalism a bit strange for one reason. How can you decry a vandalism which is protected by the state? Look at this situation. There is a vandalist, an extreme vandalism is being practiced. These girls, they are being targeted, and the state supports it. The state is actually saying, yes, I think you people are right. I must arrest these girls.
Yeah.
Any country can only be the way its people are. And here we have a state, the government, indirectly, tacitly supports these people in doing what they have done. The state has tacitly supported their actions by saying what these girls have done is wrong. We are arresting these girls. We have to get these girls to apologize. Why are we then blaming these vandals? They are state protected. After all, we can't be greater than our own state. And this is what the state government is. This is what, and I'm sorry to hear, there were so many people because of their political compulsions this evening on your panel.
Yes.
Who are trying to sideline the issue. They're not coming out and decrying it and
not
saying,
at all.
Look, what happened was terrible.
I have written against this issue.
What the police have done is wrong. No, because of their political compulsions, they are trying to be diplomatic. And
right.
The moment we as a people are willing to look away and try to be diplomatic because our political compulsions need it, the police will act like this because the state feels politically it is astute to do so. And forget freedom of speech, why blame the vandals? This is the state which is doing it. The state is protecting it.
State-promoted vandalism is the argument put by Aryaman Sundaram, Ranjana Kumari in this particular case. Unfortunately, we are getting caught in this debate of who's more responsible. Those who carried out the violence or the state? Why are we being unable to take a clear position that this is a stifling of democracy? Perhaps it's a state-sponsored stifling of democracy.
Arnab, two things should make every Indian citizen very worried today. Because one, that police, which is supposed to be the law enforcers, have misused the law, have taken the law in a wrong way and have really victimized two innocent citizens. That should mean that police can as and when use the law against citizen and can get away with that unless these policemen are punished. And secondly, the state has caved in to the politics of vandalism, and you have very rightly put that should Maharashtra tolerate this kind of a politics of fear and vandalism, and how long? And I'm sure if it was two boys who were writing it, the police would not have acted like that. Two simple innocent girls who wanted to express their opinion. I have read their the total statement very carefully, word by word, and I can tell you there was nothing whatsoever for which they have invoked 66A of the IT Act. They have invoked so many other laws. This is absolutely unjust. This is undemocratic. This is absolutely, the nation should not tolerate that, because the police and the state of Maharashtra has connived together. Their police have really, in a very clear way, has violated the constitution of India.
Anil Desai of the Shiv Sena is with us tonight. We have a big panel. We are opening this up and we are getting a lot of reactions as well.
What, Anil, and Shiv Sena's fear to prevail over the politics of Maharashtra.
Fear
it has
factor.
Been too long that Shiv Sena's fear, politics of fear, has prevailed in Maharashtra.
Anil Desai,
I think
one second.
Of
let's get.
Should wake up to
yes,
this.
Ranjana Kumari. Let's get the Shiv Sena in. Anil Desai, the politics of fear will not work. It will not work in a young India. You can put fear once on one person, second time on a second person. A country as big as ours. This politics is going to come back at you. Don't you think it is unfortunate that some Shiv Senics took the advantage of a government struck by fear to make the government spineless enough to make the girls apologize and not take action against them?
I think our leader and spokesperson Sanjay Raut has very, very much cleared this regarding this incidents. And politics to create a fear in the minds of people, that is not advocated by Shiv Sena. And if spontaneously, if any incidents takes place,
spontaneously,
you just cannot,
200 people going
you,
break
just,
house
you just
to?
Cannot. I'm not
there
very sure because I've not
it.
Gone into it
Arnab,
since I was busy.
But let me speak.
Arnab, when you have asked me the question,
Ranjana Kumari, let him speak. Ranjana Kumari, let him answer.
Yeah.
Let him answer, and I assure you, he will take questions from everyone as well.
No, but he is justifying it.
Let him make a complete point. If he is justifying it, let me ask him directly, are you justifying it? Let him answer. And then I'm going to take everyone who questions you. I'm sure he'll answer them tonight. Anil Desai, go ahead.
You just, because Sena as such never educated this kind of vandalism. In fact, if you go back to even in Ganpati festival, when NDA had called for ban, the nationwide ban was called. And since Ganpati festival was there, people were engaged, people loved the festival. It is number one festival in Maharashtra. And we were the one, I mean, who came out very openly, Shiv Sena Executive President Uddhavji. He requested the leaders of the people, because said, telling them that this is the thing which is happening in Maharashtra.
No, you're not answering my question.
I'm answering. So if you go to see, this kind of things. When late Mr. Rajiv Gandhi.
No, I'm asking you.
Listen,
you're digressing.
Listen to me.
You're digressing,
emotional,
Mr. Desai.
No. Emotional
I feel
outburst.
You are digressing.
Emotional outburst.
Emotional
maybe,
outburst
maybe
means
no,
what?
No. Listen
means
to
what?
Me. Listen to me. Late
He's
Mr. Late Mr. Rajiv Gandhi. After his assassination, the way things have happened and the way Congress people had given the reason.
So what are you just?
They came out with the argument that bahut bada, when the big tree gets uprooted, this
violence. You're justifying it.
Again.
Are you justifying it?
No. The Congress went that way. And you
sir,
have,
I have one
you
simple
have,
question
you have no
for
reason,
you.
You.
I have one
no
simple question
to,
for you, Mr. Anil
no
Desai. Take
you,
my question tonight.
No,
my question.
To me.
Sir, take my
you
question.
You have asked me the question. Let me
sir,
complete. So you have no reason to relate that way.
Sir, my question to you is this. I have two straight questions for you, Mr. Desai.
Yeah.
One, it is very convenient, isn't it, to say our official line is there must be no violence. But if some violence happens, we'll say it's an emotional outburst of some people. Second, that's what. So, you know, first question I have for you, it's a very convenient position you're taking. The second question I have for you, Mr. Anil Desai, straight and point blank. Do you believe, Mr. Desai, and does your party believe that those hundreds of boys who went in and broke the hospital, took patients out, were cowards. Do you believe they were cowards?
No, absolutely not. I'm differing on this.
Were they cowards?
What I'm telling you, Arnav, see, you have a very straight away asking a pointer. I'm replying to it. What I'm saying is, we never advocate this kind of things.
No, but it happened.
We never advocate this kind of things. We don't endorse this kind of...
But it has happened. People have taken your party's name. People have taken your party's position. One second. Arevan Sundaram is countering
you. Do you condemn this kind of thing?
Do you condemn this kind of thing? This kind of incident? Why don't you condemn it then?
Condemning is one. I'm going back.
Have you condemned the arrest? Let me tell you.
When a person... And the other way around, when anybody has a freedom of expression at this point of time, when a big thing has happened, very sad demise of Sri Balasabji, and the way out of only freedom of expression is anybody is coming out, or anybody is instigated to somebody who is coming out with the status, coming out with the with whatever thoughts
therefore
they have.
You're justifying
and if any
it.
Emotional outburst or anything comes out of that way, you just can't.
No, you
relate.
Justify any
you
act
just,
of violence
just,
like
you just can't go.
You will be encouraging it.
You just can't.
Why it was
you just
justified.
Can't frame it
you are
in
not
one,
condemning
one way.
You will tomorrow.
You are not
we
condemning
why this
is,
all this and
no, why this is
here.
Why this is very dangerous argument. I'll tell you why. Because by this you can justify any Valentine's Day protest, you can justify any Keenan and Reuben case murders, you can say that was also emotional outburst, you can justify any closing down of cinema halls, you can justify the blackening of faces, you can justify anything, you can justify the breaking of pubs, you can justify entering Supreme Court chambers and beating up lawyers, you can justify anything and you can say what to do, it's an emotional outburst. Is there something called the confines of the law is my argument. If the law does not exist, let the state of India say law is dead.
It's a new law, it's a law of the street.
I want to go to Mohandas Pai. Let's get Mohandas Pai in to hear what his, how he views it. Mohandas Pai, your response to the Shiv Sena member of parliament who says talks about an emotional response tonight.
Before anybody responds, I would say, well, Arnav, in 93 Arnav, when riots Arnav, had broken out, when things were Arnav, going out of hands of everybody, no law enforcement agency was able to contain it. Shiv Sena and Balasabji's wording Arnav, words sir, were enough I, for Shiv Sainiks to contain
sir,
it.
Sir, yes.
When Sikhs were taken very rudely by other people, political,
sir,
political
your,
people,
the allegation against
the
your
we
party
the
people
one.
Is that they locked Shiv Sena, the one who came to the rescue of Sikhs. They locked Shaheen's family and did not allow them to accompany her to the police station.
There are a number of events which have taken place.
Women are not allowed to be summoned to a police station.
Where government agency or law enforcement agency was not able to contain. I want you to tell me today.
Because
of Balasabji.
Sir, you are looking at one side of the
able to rescue
Anil Desai ji, you are looking at one side of the coin. The fact is there a law in this country or not? No, law in this country. No, if there is a law in this
country.
No, if there is a law in this country.
Violating the law of the country. Arnav, I want to say something about this. I think it is irresponsible and shameless. I'm sure the senior leadership of Shiv Sena will realize that something has gone basically wrong with the cadre.
I want to go to Mohandas Pai.
Defending something which is not defendable at all.
Mohandas Pai is now responding.
Midnight.
Mohandas Pai.
Justifiable. Arnav, do you think pressurizing the girls to apologize is justifiable?
It's unfortunate that the girls have had to apologize. It should be the other way around.
So I think
Arnav, Mohandas Pai is responding. Please, Ranjana Kumari, allow Mohandas Pai. Mohandas Pai is responding to three Shiv Sena people on our show tonight. Shweta Parulekar is with us tonight. Shweta Parulekar, Anil Desai, and I am yet to go across to Prem Shukla, who's executive editor of Dopahar Ka Samna. Mohandas Pai to Anil Desai, please. Go ahead.
Arnav is a classic case of the failure of the state.
That's true.
You have seen many political parties capture the state and use it for their own purposes. There's been a history of people who get violent, who are not punished, and who get away because they belong to a political party. The police have been politicized. And the police have been captured by certain political parties. And it's very clear there is no rule of law. Unless the state enforces the rule of law, it is going to happen. And Bombay has seen these incidents for a long period of time continuously, and people are not being punished. So there is no fear of the law.
But why is the law afraid of goons, MN Singh?
Because the law has been
captured. Who is the law for? For lawbreakers or for citizens?
Political elements.
No, is it so easy to influence? Is it so easy to influence law, you know, the police? To put fear in the police? How much fear can there be in a police?
Absolutely.
Did the police essentially say that day that let everybody do what they want to? And if any citizen says anything in protest, put them in lockup. That's, was that the unwritten writ?
Well, Arnav, let me put it very...
MN Singh.
Let me put it very straight. As the ex-police chief, I am terribly embarrassed the way the police behaved. It was totally wrong application of law. And these girls were arrested for no crimes that they had committed under the law. I am terribly embarrassed that the police, the Palghar police, succumbed to the pressure or the threats of some goons and arrested these girls. I think the Palghar police made monkeys out of them. I certainly condemn this action and condemn the action of this.
What would you say to Anil Desai on the other side of the table today?
I feel terribly embarrassed as a policeman.
I appreciate. What would you say to Anil Desai, who's right on the other side of the table today? And he says...
He realizes that what has happened was wrong. No, only thing is not coming out...
Anil Desai, he says you realizes it, you're just worried about coming out in a forthright
I think it's
manner.
Better you say that yes, it was a wrong thing and you condemn. That is the best way,
Mr. Desai,
I think, to put an end to this. Because
in
you
fact,
just cannot justify anything which is wrongly done. Innocent girls, in my opinion, they have committed no crime under the law. Tell me if there is any crime that they have committed. Why were they arrested?
No, let him respond.
How many debates were held and what kind of response and what kind of conclusion you could arrive at to as far as Azad Maidan's vandalism was concerned?
Several.
What conclusion?
I don't even know. Several.
How many?
Several. It was pushed. It was pushed, and an ineptitude of the state was discussed on at least four consecutive nights here on Times Now.
Similarly,
so that argument doesn't hold.
Despite that, if that argument doesn't hold, you cannot say that. But despite that, here also, whatever action is being taken or whoever have been faced,
inaction.
Action, you can say. See, every aspect can be defined by you as okay. as a media. You can define the things in your own
sure.
perspective. You just can't. As everybody expresses one's opinion,
can I ask a question as a citizen?
Yes, go ahead.
The question I have is very simple. Does my friend wish to defend what has happened or justify it? Or does he wish to condemn it? We all know what has happened. There were actions of vandalism. And to compound matters, the state supported it. Supported it not just tacitly, but expressly, by not only arresting the girls, but then getting them to apologize. I did not hear one word of condemnation from the political party concerned.
No, Mr. Anil Desai is saying law will take its own course.
Apology.
No, Mr. Anil Desai is saying law will take its own course.
Whether even today they are condemning it or not.
Prem Shukla, executive editor of Dopahar Ka Samna, is responding to your question, it seems. Go ahead, Prem Shukla. Go ahead.
नहीं बहुत सीधी सी बात है कि जब पैगंबर मोहम्मद साहब का एक कार्टून डेनमार्क में बनता है और उसका अपमान होता है तो पूरे भारत में प्रदर्शन होता है, हिंसापात होता है. हमारे पैगंबर, हमारे खुदा शिवसेना प्रमुख का अपमान किया जाता है. शिवसैनिक पहले जाकर समझाने की कोशिश करते हैं धड़ा परिवार को. धड़ा परिवार के लोग उसके बाद अपमान किया गया है, अपमानजनक टिप्पणियां की जाती है
आपकी
और उनका माथा भड़कता है.
कोई थोड़ी सी हिंसा बात होती है,
आप कार्रवाई तो कर रहे हैं.
सीधी बात, सीधा सवाल आपसे ये है,
एकदम गलत बात हुई है और अपमान किया गया है.
एक मिनट, एक मिनट, एक मिनट. आपके आपके आपके
की गई है,
भड़का है.
Do not agree that Shiv Sena Pramukh ka apman hua. In ladkiyon ne jo message bheja us
one at a time. One minute. One at a time.
This is absolutely wrong interpretation of what the girls wrote.
One minute.
And I don't think
उस लड़की को समझाने की कोशिश की गई, उस लड़की ने उस समय भी जिस तरह का रिएक्शन दिया, उससे जो वहां पर संवेदना बढ़ी, उसका दुष्परिणाम भुगतना
पड़ा।
एक्शन हो रहा है।
I think this is an attempt to communalize the whole debate and to communalize the whole incident. This is condemnable. There was absolutely.
प्रेम शुक्ला जी, एक मिनट आप मेरी बात सुनिए, एक मिनट, रंजना कुमारी 1 मिनट, प्रेम शुक्ला जी एक मिनट बात सुनिए, आपने बात रखी है तो एक मिनट आप दूसरे तरफ से भी बात सुनिए, क्योंकि दूसरी बात यह है, अगर
एक
मेरा सवाल से ये है, इट्स 1 मिनट, एवरीबडी हैज अ राइट टू गो टू पुलिस स्टेशन।
व्हाई ब्लेम द पुलिस इफ आवर पॉलिटिकल लीडर्स फील दिस वे? Why blame the police?
I am asking.
Why blame the people who actually did it?
When
our political leaders feel this way.
I am asking today.
No, Mr. Sundaram, the police must stand firm in such occasions. There is no excuse for the policemen to buckle down like this under threats of gundas. No, this is not acceptable argument, Mr. Sundaram. The police are capable of dealing with situations like this.
Now the situation is done.
There is just no question.
One at a time. May I request all the panelists one at a time, please?
I think it was wrong comparing that Prophet Muhammad episode and this episode. In the message, there is no mention of Sri Bala Sahib Thackeray, there is no mention of Shiv Sena, there is no mention of any religion or anything like that. It is you are trying to, Mr. Shukla, you are trying to communalize the whole issue, and this is very objectionable.
No, I just want to one minute,
पूरे सिचुएशन
आप मेरी बात रंजना कुमारी जी आई विल कम टू यू मिस्टर शुक्ला एंड रंजना कुमारी, वन मिनट प्लीज, आई रिक्वेस्ट बोथ ऑफ यू 1 मिनट। माय क्वेश्चन टुनाइट इज दिस, सिंपली दिस, व्हाटएवर योर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, हूएवर यू फॉलो, हूएवर यू रिवेयर, इफ इज देयर अ लॉ इन दिस कंट्री एज पर द लॉ, हु ब्रोक द लॉ फॉर हुम? Why was there? Why did the police take the girls to a police station after 10 o'clock at night? It's not allowed. One minute. Why is it? Why was the family not allowed to accompany them to the police station? One. A third question is, if you have gone and filed a complaint in the police station, let the procedure happen in the police station. On what basis do you just go, hundreds of you, and vandalize a relative of the person?
Yes.
Who has filed that case? How can you go indulge it? You see, you go through the legal procedure, and after that, if the police makes a mistake, fine, criticize the police. But you cannot approach the law at the same time, Mr. Desai, and indulge in violence on the other together. These cannot be two simultaneous processes. Right. That will be called blackmailing the police, saying if you don't take action, we'll take the action on our own, or we'll take the action and then we'll force you to also take action. So it's double trouble. For the victim in this case, Abha wants to make a point, then I'm coming back to you. Abha.
Police is scared of this only of the deterioration of law and order.
And
that is why police buckles. And if he's talking of 92-93 riots, till now there has been not a single conviction.
No, but we are not talking about 92-93 riots.
But what I'm saying is that even now, instead of condemning, if you see the people here, they are trying to justify it under emotional outburst. And there is no regret, there is no remorse.
They are proudly taking the fact that they have done a great thing. Shweta.
I think we are taking this in the wrong perspective. I am not justifying that at all. Vandalism is not something which anybody will like to justify ever. That is number one. I'd like to make that very clear. Nobody will ever try to say that what our people did was right. Second thing is that was a reaction to an action. It could have been done in another way.
They
I'm
can't
sure.
be violent. Reactions cannot be allowed. Ranjana Kumari, let Shweta Parulekar complete. I'll come to you.
Innocent statement, opinion of a girl. How can you really react by violence?
Yeah,
and
Let me put the fact before you. Ranjana Kumari and Abha, I would just like to request you, please. I made the point.
FIR against unknown persons.
Okay, one second.
When you are seeing on the clipping,
let her complete and then I have a question.
She was saying that why don't you suspend these people? Now, number one, Honorable Uddhavji will take a call on on that, that what exactly has to be done with them, and he'll definitely take whatever action is to be taken. Number two is the most important thing is that whenever a common citizen reacts to opines, don't you think, Arnab, that they have some responsibility, or they don't?
No, certainly
they
do.
Just can
certainly
do whatever they
do.
Want.
One minute. Certainly,
and we just keep on looking at
Shweta ji, I'll tell you
but
clear answer to that.
In my opinion, they have said nothing objectionable.
No,
that
sir.
Should really provoke people.
That's
to
a subjective
like
matter.
This.
That's a subjective
that
matter.
Is subjective,
they have just
sir.
Expressed an opinion no. about the bun.
That was the last
hardship
thing.
That the people no. face. That's
no, no, no,
it.
No,
that's about it all.
I'd say to that, to your question, I'd say that it's a subjective matter. And my follow up point to you is whatever their grievance, they have taken it to the police. There is a process. Now, you cannot start your own form of vigilante justice that I will complain to the police station at the same time because I have some muscle, I'll get 100 people, smash you, break your car, teach you a lesson that you will not forget for the rest of your life, take you to a police station after 10 o'clock, embarrass you, make sure that your family cannot follow you, make you cry, make an example of you, and so that the fear factor is not just in you, in the hearts of people forever, that if you dare to question us, then you will face not the law, but our law. Then Indian law does not matter.
But Arnab,
Shweta.
The police should answer this, you know. Shiv Sena can't answer on behalf of
the police,
number
were
one.
Bullied.
No, sir,
police
so one
were,
more thing.
Police were so, pressurized to act in the
no,
manner. When
police,
a mob of 100, 200 people come to the police station and put
timidly.
Pressure on this under the threat of violence in the city,
if you
probably
saw the
they,
response,
were, they thought it.
So one more small thing which I'd like to mention.
Can I, the police,
yes. I agree,
if you saw
they should not have done
from
what
the
they
police
did.
Yesterday, it was so timid, it was almost as if they were justifying their incompetence. I think that is where every citizen needs to know that if there is a misuse of law, they the guilty are going to be brought to task.
Simply saying, China, in this country, we feel proud of our freedom of expression. One minute. Shweta,
absolutely,
see,
that's
you,
the way
you
it should
see,
be.
The young people of this country today, you know, I'm sure that as a political party, Anil ji, you too want to be in sync with the way the young people of this country think. The young people of this country will not be bullied, Anil ji. They will not be bullied. You can beat up 121-year-old, you can beat up 121, break 121-year-old's uncle's hospital, you can make her cry, you can make her weep, you can embarrass her, you can humiliate her, you can make her family force her to backtrack, you know, you can create, you can bully one young person. Do you think sometimes that this form of vigilante justice is outdated? In India of 2012, it's very dangerous. It's because anybody can do this. Is the easiest form of instant justice. Anybody who can get a few people together can start implementing it tomorrow on the streets, playing
and
with fire.
And there can be a counter movement.
And there can be a counter movement also. You agree with me? You're a lawmaker. You're in the parliament.
Arnav ji, late Mr. Balasaheb ji, his funeral was attended by more than 2.5 million people. They were there right from the time when the procession started from Kalanagar, Bandra. And it was a ocean of the people, ocean-like people were there.
Yes.
They respected, they revered Balasaheb ji. See, we, not only we, but people have that kind of place in their heart.
So
listen to me.
Nobody denies.
And on that particular day, very next day, if any kind of comes on the social networking sites and all that, then
this young lady was questioning the shutdown of the city. She was saying, why should the city be shut down? And she said, when do we even have 2 minutes of silence for Bhagat Singh? For Bhagat Singh. So, you know, a young person is just expressing their view. Now, is the response? I'm asking you clearly tonight. Are you telling me that any young person in Mumbai or wherever you have your pocket boroughs of support should feel so scared that, you know, if I express my point of view, which does not have the official seal of the Shiv Sena, then tomorrow, you know, my school will be burnt down, my car will be broken, my building will be vandalized, my family members will be harassed. Would you like that to happen to any member of your family, Mr. Desai?
This is being presented,
you know,
by the media in such a fashion.
It is exactly this.
Why, why don't you come out? Why don't you come out? You see the things which have been done by Shiv Sena in the past. When Kashmiris had problems, it was Balasaheb Ji.
Sure, this has nothing to do with that. This has nothing to do with that.
Nothing.
And on Sunday, and on Sunday, and on Sunday. No, I'm not conveniently. I'm not conveniently.
No,
on Sunday, when many people came out, everybody appreciated, including on this channel, and China was there, appreciated the orderliness. Shweta was there that day. We appreciated the orderliness of the entire function.
Today, Shiv Sena people believe in. People have, besides this political support or the government support, they are more relying on what Shiv Sena can do.
Violence has no place in a democracy. And you cannot stifle the young people of India by violence.
Have you ever brought this on the media that whenever any natural calamity has taken place, where serious accidents have taken place, where bomb blasts have taken place, before government machinery
What I'm telling you is today
this is the fact. You can go.
Young people of India will not be bullied.
You can have a random
young people of India cannot be bullied.
You can have a survey conducted.
My view is, sir, you have a survey conducted.
You are not making me speak. I'm telling you.
Anil Desai.
If you have your sources, you can go for random survey and ask the people the very question.
You would have condemned.
Who do you believe in? Who? What kind of faith you have in political parties?
Mr. Anil Desai.
I'm telling you, it is Shiv Sena number one.
Mr. Anil Desai, can I ask you one question? You have a survey and you ask young people a survey, will young people of India be bullied? Believe me, Mr. Anil Desai, you will find it was young crowd
of 20s and 30s, where they were forming the maximum,
but they also won't be bullied if those people are never bullied.
On the contrary,
why are we sidelining the fact of non-performance of the government?
I have said it yesterday and today. I have begun the news by saying that the state government has become spineless.
Program for sure.
No, if the state...
I think two things needs to be said in the program for sure. One, that all the cases against the girls needs to be withdrawn with immediate effect. I think state needs to intervene. The whole nation has seen state caving into the violence and vandalism of Shiv Sena. It is Shiv Sena who is the savior of the people. We are there for the people. Violence has no place. Violence, we don't advocate, as I said. Why don't they put all those girls and boys who are repeating the same message, lakhs and lakhs of messages?
Okay, let's take one quick response from Mohandas Pai, who's been listening patiently. Yes, Mohandas Pai, you heard the debate here today.
Arnab, I'm hearing the debate, but what makes me sad is that the political leaders on this talk seem to justify violence. Whatever be the differences, whatever be the provocation, they can never justify violence. We should never justify violence and make sure that citizens are free from violence. The police have become a party to the violence, and the reason is that the political leaders support them.
Prem Shukla ji, hinsa ko chhodne ka samay aa gaya hai. हिंसा को किसी तरह से भी जस्टिफाई नहीं की जा सकती. आप अग्री करते हैं मेरे साथ? हिंसा को छोड़िए,
लेकिन कोई हमारा माथा
नहीं नीति अपनाइए.
शिव सैनिकों का माथा कोई भड़काएगा तो अरे का जवाब.
आप तो धमकी दे रहे हैं. धमकी नहीं दे रहे हम.
वो जिस तरह से जब धड़ा परिवार को समझाने गए तो उनका जो एटीट्यूड था उसकी भी आप जांच करा लें.
ठीक है, ओके. प्रेम शुक्ला जी, नाउ आई एम रैपिंग अप टुनाइट. आई जस्ट वांट टू से वन थिंग. आई बिलीव violence has no place. B, vandalism must stop. And I genuinely believe that the young people of India have had enough. The young people of India in 2012 will not be bullied. Maybe the Shiv Sena needs to reevaluate its position, but it's a democracy. At least we've had a debate today. To the Shiv Sena representatives who have come, to the representative of the Samna, to Mohandas Pai, Ariman Sundaram, Ranjana Kumari, Shaina, NC, Abhaji, Mr. Shukla, and of course, MN Singh, I thank you very, very much for joining me on this News Hour debate tonight. Thank you very much indeed. I'd like your feedback on that. Do you believe that the young people of India, in whatever subject, not just this, can be bullied anymore? I want to hear from you. See you tomorrow, same time. Good night and goodbye.